You've got quite famous though, haven't you, through Emily?
Yeah.
Haven't you?
Yeah.
You're popping up everywhere. I'm sorry. You're popping up everywhere.
Am I?
Yeah, the algorithm's like going for it. Yeah.
Oh, I like that. It's because I'm like you, Ross. I don't care.
Give a shit.
I really don't.
So many people on social media give a shit, right? And they want that perfect thing. I don't really give a shit. I'll tell someone if I've shat myself that day. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't care about it. I'm praying to a Lord above that mum doesn't come out with anything like that. Can you imagine? Ross said it, so I'm going to go on and say
it. Well, it was like time.
Today, I laughed a bit too hard and, a bit of poo came out.
There, I've said it.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Emily Blackwell's Mother Half podcast. We are here again for yet another weekly little catch-up. And just a little, you know, you guys can just switch off and...
Laugh
and just realise...
Oh, you're really going to laugh this time.
...that your life isn't that bad because ours is probably worse.
Here we go. Should we get straight in or do you want a little catch-up?
I think we just get straight into
Let's
it this week.
Very excited for this one.
Otherwise, we just ramble on me and you and... Yeah.
Would you? But I am super duper excited for this. We have got the lovely Ross with AKA Dad Daddy on the couch with us today. Ross Woods and Lawrence Woods.
Ooh! Welcome,
Hello.
Welcome, gang.
How are you?
We're good, you know. We're very good.
How are you?
Good. Do you know what? I'm reasonably well and good. We had a bad journey in. Nearly saw a dog get knocked over, but I saved it. Also had a bit of vegan cake, so all's good this morning, yeah.
That sounds like a really good Tuesday for me.
It started off well, yeah.
Just a cappuccino for me.
He can't have too much caffeine, you see, Dad.
No.
Because he'll piss himself.
Well, to be honest, Mum can't have too much caffeine either.
Really?
No. Now, talking of buzzes, we've got a bar for you.
Malibu and Coke. You got my request, didn't you?
Yes, you did.
Yeah,
of course you did.
Malibu and Coke,
what a drink. I haven't heard, barely anyone drinks that these days.
No, I know. And all my friends, because I don't have many male friends, because I'm a bit of a metrosexual, but some of my male friends, I get them to order it for me, because it's just funny when they go up to the bar and they're getting a beer and they go, yeah, mate, Malibu and Coke, who's that for your wife? No, him in the corner.
I'll have whatever's going. I'm easy. Gin and tonic,
don't you, Dad?
I can't have gin. It makes me aggressive. I actually, funny story about one time I drank gin, probably not sure I should even... explain this story, especially in front of people I barely know, but anyway.
Let's do it.
The last time I had gin, was an ex boyfriend of mine.
Yeah.
I ran up to him and punched him in the face. And he said, what'd you do that for? And I said, I don't know.
What, out
I can't
of nowhere?
Remember. How rogue is that? Never drank gin since. Not like a full blown punch, but like a, I don't know, or maybe it was my handbag or something, but yeah.
How many gins did you have?
Quite a few, I think. I couldn't remember why I'd wanted to hurt him. So. How random.
Listen.
So this is a daiquiri.
Yeah, strawberry daiquiri.
God, I feel like I'm on holiday.
Chin chin, everyone.
That's nice. That's full of sugar.
Really am. But do you know what's quite nice? Obviously, you guys are, same but different dynamic to us.
Yeah, the male version of...
The male version.
Male version of us.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. You embarrass
I do. Well, you have to, don't
I
you?
I embarrass
you think,
Emily.
So you do it the other way around. I've always tried to embarrass my parents or my friends. That's my role in life, really.
Love that.
That's what I've always tried to do.
Yeah, that's
I'm always thrown under the bus.
Yeah.
What?
You've got to throw your parents under the bus because the years of them bringing us up, like telling us what to do, then it has to change round at some point.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I'm still waiting for that. That day for
just
me.
Any opportunity, Emily, just do it.
It's more of a telling off. It's not like an embarrassing thing. She likes to embarrass me and then I just have to, you know, shut her down.
Well, go on.
Get to your room now.
Bedtime,
you are grounded.
Get on the naughty step.
Yeah. I have been told bedtime a couple of
have
times
you?
When I was drunk.
No, I've said I think you need a nap just to calm down.
A nap.
A nanny nap.
What, a Sunday afternoon nap?
Yeah, after nanny.
Don't talk about that, right? Dad's naps, right? I'm not fucking joking.
Under the
bus. Yeah, this is, he's such a lightweight. How old are you now? Tell everyone.
Knocking 66.
66, so
good.
A good, 50 odd years of drinking, right? He still can't handle it. Two red wine. If he gets the second glass of red wine ready, right? I say, right, see you in the morning, Dad. Do you know what I mean?
Oh,
his
really?
Head's hung over the sofa. You can't get a word out. Ridiculous.
Well, two. God, watch
two.
Out. You'll be fine. Your head will be
I know.
Back off the
no,
sofa.
It's all right.
Now.
It's fine. This is fine.
It's only a little cheeky. Yeah, no, it's only a single shot gin and tonic.
single shot. That'll do him.
You're quite a heavyweight, to be fair.
Oh, I am.
But I think it's because you're actually immune.
My liver's like that.
You got immune liver.
Yeah. I think, yeah, she's marinated that damn thing for a good few years now.
You've got quite famous, though, haven't you, through Emily?
Yeah.
Haven't you?
Yeah.
You're popping up everywhere. I'm sorry. You're popping up everywhere.
Am I?
Yeah, the algorithm's like going for it with you.
Oh, I like that. It's because I'm like you, Ross. I don't care.
Give a shit.
I really don't.
This is it with social media.
That is good. Yeah.
So many people on social media give a shit, right? And they want that perfect thing. I don't really give a shit. I'll tell someone if I've shat myself that day. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm praying to a Lord above that mum doesn't come out with anything like that. But can you imagine? Ross said it, so I'm going to go on and say
it. Well, it was like time.
Today, I laughed a bit too hard and, a bit of poo came out.
There, I've said it.
There, I've said it. No, I've never pooed my pants. I can make one up. No trouble.
Can do.
There I was, laying on my sun lounger, had a curry the night before on the local takeaway in Tenerife. Oh,
don't talk about curries. It was a biscuit.
No, I'm joking. I've just made that all up, Ross.
Okay.
But that could happen.
So you could just do it.
I thought it was a biscuit.
Yeah, air biscuit. That's what you call farts, isn't it?
Air biscuit.
Is it? I thought it was a love puff.
Oh, don't call it a love puff.
I used to call it a lady fluff. What are you calling it?
A lady fluff.
Yeah, the kids go, Mum, open the window on the school run.
A lady fluff.
Stop it. I've just done a lady fluff.
It's like a merkin, isn't it? A lady fluff.
A merkin.
Do you know what a merkin is?
No.
Pubic wig. You've never.
That's
the actual proper name for it.
Yeah.
Who would want to do that?
Oh, Dad's got one.
Merkin.
Did you lose all your hair when you get older? Didn't you?
Bald as a coot.
Bald as a coot down there, so has to get himself a merkin. Looks brilliant. You can get any colour, Rachel. Don't worry about it.
Apparently people can lose their pubic hair in menopause.
Yeah.
Oh, well, here we go.
So guys, I'll be ordering you a merkin for Christmas.
I wouldn't want an old babushka going on.
Cake bushes.
Yeah. Don't want the old Brillo pad.
No.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't want to.
We've really dived into this one, haven't we?
We've come out the starting blocks well.
Yeah, very odd conversation.
Now, you, every morning, you get in your car. I can never do these live ones. Yeah. I always look dreadful. But how do you come up with this funny stuff? You make me laugh every day. Thank you.
Ross is very big on TikTok.
Yeah.
Just so in case audience aren't aware. But yeah, very big on TikTok and very good at your videos.
Accidentally fell into it. It was lockdown, really. And we're at home and I thought, TikTok came about, didn't it?
It did, yeah.
So I started, I'd done a random TikTok one day. And it just took off and like Eva Longoria started using. Actually, I'll tell you the quick story. I was in my house. I was doing a pizza for myself. My wife was sitting down. My phone started going off because I'd done a TikTok that morning. And Eva Longoria used sound and it was being shared and shared and shared. I thought, oh my fucking God. And then my wife said, what have you been doing? I hope you haven't been doing TikToks because you can't fucking dance, right? And I went, I have it. She went, well, you can stop that. Right? It's embarrassing. So I carried on, of course, behind her back. And I kind of hit like 50,000 followers within, I don't know, a month. And then it just skyrocketed. And I was in the car with you, weren't I?
Yeah, I mean, it was just amazing how it went. It just escalated.
Mm.
At first, I wasn't liking it because of the language that was being used. So
shut up.
After
Are you joking?
No, when he hit around about 35,000, I thought, this is really motoring, mate.
Fucking get on with it, son.
Yeah, go for it. But what he actually created, I felt, was at the time, it's like when you open up a newspaper and you get a comic strip. He's created a comic strip every day. So people keep coming back to
it.
That's
kind
of what happened. Yeah, and then like I was going to bed at night thinking, oh, shit, I've got to think of another one now. Or then what happened to me? But it just kept falling into place, and I was just doing one every morning. Then if I missed one, people were going, oh my God, have you been hit by a car? Are you in hospital? I was getting like weird DMs going,
where are you?
And it just went off. And then, Channel 4 approached me and said, would you do this reality TV? Well, you're all, you know, about reality TV. And I thought, I can't do it. I cannot do it because I just shit myself. I thought, no way.
What one did they do?
Rise and Fall.
Oh, you actually did it?
Yeah, Rise and Fall with Greg J. It was basically Studio Lambert who done The Traitors, and all my cousins and family go, you fucking idiot, you should have done The Traitors. Rise and Fall was a one-hit one. They done it last year?
Last year. What actually happened was about 2 weeks prior, Ross gets a phone call and they want to interview me.
They wanted him as well.
They wanted me as well. So I went down, I'd done the casting, but it was a bit too much because of work commitments.
So
they take your mobile, your watch as well, wasn't it?
3 weeks without your mobile. They were trying to rival Big Brother. So they were trying to do a big thing. You were in a basement of this thing, like a house, and then you had to eat. I lost a stone and a half in there. That was the best thing.
Stone and a half on you to lose, is there?
Oh, there is, babes. So I've put it on.
Oh, yeah, yes. He tucks it away.
I've tucked it away, yeah. We're one of those.
He's got his girdle on.
I've got my girdle. Yeah, so it was a very intense thing. And it was like 3 weeks in there, no phone, no contact with the family. So I've got a little boy, and he was 2 at the time. I thought, I can't leave him. But my wife said, don't be an idiot. He won't remember. And so I done it. And it was amazing. But like, you know, reality TV, it's not all what it seems, if you like. You're very scripted in there. And I thought I could be myself. They made me out to look like a wet lettuce. Do you know what I mean? I was crying. They made you cry. So it was like a diary room, right? And you would go in there, do a task. Like, they put us in these treadmills and it was like 40 degree heat. And you had to run to make money, basically, for the person to win it. And I failed it. Like, I was shit. I fell off the treadmill. Like, it was embarrassing. And they got me in this room after this diary room and said, oh my God, you lost all that money and you're doing it for your little boy, right? And I thought, oh my God, my eyes, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I told you about it. It just really affected me. And I was just crying all the time. And I'm never really that emotional. But when you are in there without family, it was just crazy.
The bubble.
So it was a bubble.
I think they aimed it at getting to your emotions.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, of course they do.
Of course they do in anything.
Yeah.
And it was good TV.
So what's your relationship like?
Mine and Dad's?
Yeah.
Do you want to?
I think we're very close.
Yeah.
We're always having a laugh.
So you work with each other, don't you?
Yeah, we do now. Yeah, I never did do. My mum's a hairdresser. My mum and dad split up when I was about 7.
Yes, that was sad.
Yeah, it was sad.
We just grew apart.
Yeah, Emily's and
like teenagers got dad. Together yep. and then grew apart.
Are
yeah.
you friendly now?
We speak. We're friendly. There's no...
No, they're all talking to
There's no darts being thrown at each other.
That's
no.
funny. Well, it's a bit like you and Dad, I guess.
Yeah, I've got the utmost respect for Dean. He's a lovely guy and a lovely dad.
I think when you get divorced or you separate, even if you're not married, there is poison on both sides. And then all of a sudden that disappears.
Yeah, time.
And then...
It's time, yeah.
It's time. Then you get together and you sort out your differences. And then you become best of friends and you start talking again.
Well, you did something special together. You had children together.
Yes.
Unfortunately, so, made me.
Yeah.
Ross, you know what I mean?
Have you got any brothers or sisters?
No. Yeah, I
yes,
have.
Yes, he has.
Oh. Joking. I've got a sister. She's 2 years older than me. Yeah. So
yeah,
she's,
Holly.
She's kind of... I get on her nerves as well. Basically, she's the intelligent one out of us. She's like a teacher.
She's more academic.
She's more academic,
book smart, we like to call it.
Book smart.
Yeah.
And you're street smart.
I'm street smart.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah.
Everyone's smart in this room.
Yeah. So, what?
Street smart.
Street smart.
You're having a laugh.
Okay. but no, I think our relationship is good. I've got a very similar relationship with my mum. I'm close to both parents.
That's nice.
So I was basically, because when you split up, my nan and mum kind of brought me up and it was a very kind of women orientated, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's why you are like you are now.
Yeah, slightly gay.
Yeah.
We need to dive into this.
We do, because
people... I love it.
I say I'm homosexual, I just don't like cock, right? Yeah. That's me.
No, it's penis.
Okay? Penis.
You don't like
or the
penis.
Old cockage, right?
Cockage.
Why would anyone want to put that in their mouth? But
not you.
Not me. Yeah.
But you've got a glorious wife and a beautiful...
I thought you were about to say something else.
I've got a glorious penis. It has been known. No, my wife is glorious. Yeah, and I've got a lovely little boy.
It worked once, didn't it?
Yeah, it worked once. So... It's
You're
just
in
weird.
Touch with your feminine side.
Oh, absolutely. My mum's a hairdresser and she taught me how to cut hair at a really young age. I used to skive off school, go with her and do all hair and stuff like that. And then I was cabin crew for 7 years. So that's another really heavily male job. That was really British Midland back in the day.
Yeah, that is back in the day.
Yeah, so I'd done that all through my 20s. It was a great job.
So when you met your wife...
So my wife, this was a weird story. She was a singer and a dancer in the West End. So she'd done Grease the Musical, Mamma Mia, all of that. Yeah, so we went to high school together for the last 2 years of high school. She hated me. I had blonde curtains and I was quite chubby. So, and then we met up in later life, didn't we? I was flying, I think. And
was it Edinburgh?
Scotland, Aberdeen, yeah. So Facebook came about and my mate said, oh, there's loads of our friends on here. Went on there, I was more trim, sunbeds every day.
Glow up.
Shaved, glow up, shaved head, looked the absolute nuts. I was probably, looking back, I was an absolute twat. But we met up and then there you go. And then 14 years married.
14 years, yeah. But how long together?
Together 17, something. Shit, if I get this wrong, she'll listen to this.
Hold tight.
I don't know, smack I've got it, look.
What's her name? I feel it was
Lucy.
Lucy.
31st of July, I've got it tattooed 2010. That was our wedding day. Yeah.
That's so nice.
But on social, we've got to address this because I think it's brilliant. On social media, the amount, because you do camp up for it.
Absolutely.
You are, as camp as Christmas, I bloody love it.
Yeah, it's weird.
Do you have a lot of gay men, like, DM
fancy you?
I do, yeah. Well, when I was cabin crew, it's majority is gay and camp, and they used to come on to me, and I've got really funny, I don't know whether I should tell it on this. I will.
We can cut it out.
Yeah, you don't need to cut it out. It's quite fun. So I was in... when you do night stops when you're cabin crew, you know, you share rooms with, you know, it's a free-for-all. Anyway, I was single at this time. So I was in bed, right? There was a girl in the middle and a guy was on the other side, right? He's gay, right? And I was laying there and I think, oh, this is nice. I was honestly just going to go to sleep. I didn't. And then all of a sudden I felt a hand coming over, going the little pee nose.
Huge.
Adequately
large.
In size of proportion to my body.
They all fit.
They.
Yeah. I think in
endowed. Oh my God.
From what I've seen when they I was do. A kid, endowed.
Yeah. So I felt a hand coming like on it.
You'll reach round.
And I thought, hang on, lovely. Put my arm down there, felt a massive G-Shock watch, hairy arm. So I jumped out of bed. I thought, fuck this, no. And that was an encounter. Because, he thought I was gay.
And what did you say? Get off me, big
God,
gorilla.
Oh, my God, yeah. You big gorilla. I jumped out, right? Like, just startled, because I thought, no. And, people think... But everyone thinks, you've definitely had a cock up your ass. That's what they said to me. Everyone. DMs. And you think, hang on a minute.
I know my bum.
But, yeah, so if I'm with Luce and we're out and I'm messing about, she went, please, please, please try not to be as camp as you are. So I kind of decamp myself a bit. Is that a word, decamping?
Yeah, but I the camper you go, the more I laugh and
I know, sometimes I get so overly excited when I'm doing videos and really camp it up and being...
There, I said it, and you put your glasses
said it.
Up. And
yeah, I don't know where that catchphrase come from as well, and it's stuck now.
But everybody puts it on your things
I
as
know.
Well.
That's what your podcast Ross. Is going to be cool.
Yeah, so we've got a little podcast coming out.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Hopefully soon. We've done the pilot and everything, and it's going really well. So, yeah, there I said it. And I don't know where it come from. I think I said it at the end of a video once. And yeah. It went a bit crazy. And then I thought, hang on a minute. Oh, shit, I'm going to have to say it every time.
So how do you go viral on anything? I'm tinkering away. This is hard. This is vertical climbing.
Well, it's weird because this is what I've been known because I'm shit with all social media. Well, I'm not now because I've taught myself. Yeah. If you do something and it goes viral, say, like a video in your car and it's a short, quick one, you run with that kind of, how would I say it?
Genre
or tapping into that kind of
thing.
So you'll know what kind of goes viral. So you keep doing it, but that's got a longevity, hasn't it? That will just stop. So you have to keep changing up your stuff. So like I was doing the car stuff for a long while before work. And then I got a bit bored of it. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to do a few videos with Dad. And then made his head get massive because he gets noticed in Tesco's. Now they stop him and go, oh, Daddy, how are you? And then his wife, my stepmom, goes, his fucking head's massive. He's come home. Look at him. And he's sitting there like that. And you think, oh,
Billy
no.
Big Potatoes.
Yeah, big Billy.
This is
big
not
potatoes.
True.
It is true. She told me that. He got stopped in a B&M store of any place. Disgusting. They do one way in there as well, innit? One way in. Why do they do one way in a B&M store? Have you been in a B&M store?
Hell no.
Emily, have you been to a B&M store?
No.
Yeah, you have.
Yeah.
B&M store does everything. Like, if you want 20,000 tea bags, go in there, you can get them.
Like a Costco.
Yeah, like a Costco.
But
he got noticed in one of them or a Home Bargains. And I thought that's really embarrassing.
Oh, you've arrived, love.
He's arrived.
My book.
Yeah. Love's been recognised once, haven't you?
Yep.
The most awkward one I've had, right, coming up to me. Because I was in Tesco's, right? Well, I just shopped in Tesco's and I took my little boy out And I had him, and he was quite young at the time, so I was putting him into his baby seat, but he didn't want to go in. And babies, right, or youngsters, when they don't want to, they go all stiff. You won't, anyone, like they're in the fucking luge, right? So I'm trying to get him in there, and some woman's come up to me, go, are you Rossi from, yeah, from Rise and Fall? And I was like that, I was sweating, I was trying to wait, yes, I am. Like, and I came over really rude, because I'm not rude, I don't mind it, but I was actually doing something, and I was dropping stuff.
You was having a wrestle with your two-year-old.
I hope she got her timing not
the
right.
The timing was off for her. Let's call her Karen. I don't know what her name was, but it was slightly off.
Back off, Kazza, when
back
you see
back off, Kazza, when you see me with my kid.
Yeah.
I've had it a few times where, like, people have... You can tell that they know me from somewhere, but they can't work out where. So they'll be, like, scanning my food or whatever I've bought, and they'll be staring at me, and they're like... Did I go to school with you? And I get so embarrassed, I have to go, yeah, I think you did. I think I just go along with it. Yeah. I can't be like, no, I'm actually from, mate, like, probably the TV. I can't do it. So I just go along with some absolute weird story. I'm like, oh, yeah, I think I recognise you from maybe my maths class.
Do you like it if someone recognises you through what you've done on TV or, like, your social media?
There's two ways of it. So, I love it. I think it's really endearing because everyone is actually so lovely. But one of the worst things is when, like, they know what you do, but they pretend that they don't, which I think is quite cute. But I'd much rather people, do you know what, they're like, so what do you do then? And you're like, but you've just told my friend that you know.
Oh, do you know what you do. Yeah, it gets awkward.
It gets awkward, but everyone is really nice. Apart from when they say, are you from Towie? And then I'm like,
no, that's my
mum. Sorry, hang on.
But do you remember when we was in Costco and the girl was doing our, was at the till, and she's doing the beep bit. And I said, oh, Emily, you always wanted to do something like this, didn't you? And the girl looked up and went, well, we're recruiting. If she wants, I can get her
a job.
Oh, my God. No, but you'd be good at that.
But you know when you were younger and you used to have those little tills?
Yeah.
With the fake money? Yeah. And you used to go beep. Beep. I could do that for hours.
A little boy's got
so me. Yeah, I would have liked that. I wanted to do. I wanted to be policewoman. Loved the bill, and an air hostess actually. Here's a fun fact.
You'd have been good.
I did when I was 18 years old. I went to British Airways.
Yeah.
If you're watching this, why didn't you hire me? Actually, thank God you didn't. No, but and I went to do their face. Big. Their what did I do?
Recruitment.
Oh, like a
trial.
Like a
trial. Yeah.
But
oh my God, it was like X Factor.
Oh, it's horrible.
This is like, it's not just a standard interview nowadays that you do over Zoom. This is a whole day it takes. You have to go through stage one, which is something, two, which is something else. And then each time you're getting dropped out and you're getting eliminated, like the bloody Hunger Games. And then at the very
taken
end,
out.
Yeah, literally, it's like Squid Games. And then at the end, yeah, I got through to the last bit, but then they sent me an email saying, sorry, but no. I thought, Christ, took our whole day. I learned a lot there.
Oh, we slagged off people so much when we were cabin crew.
Did you ever serve anyone famous?
Yes. Alex Ferguson.
Oh, big one.
Big one.
Big one.
Man United. Oh, nice. Yeah, gave him a coffee. Who else was on there?
Just a coffee.
Just a coffee. He didn't want anything. He just wanted a coffee.
Was it a long flight or a short flight?
Short flight. That was what I think it was to Scotland and back to London Heathrow. So it's a little short one. We got up to some really naughty stuff, though. I can't believe I didn't get sacked most of the time. And I saw someone wanking someone off once. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Under the blanket. Yeah.
I
let him get on with it, though, because I thought, you've been wanked off before. What is the Mile High Club on your own?
I don't know. Half a mile high.
Yeah, half a mile high. But yeah, so I let him get on with it though, because I was like that. I thought, if it's not going to endanger the flight, you know, fill your boots, love.
No, I had a client. I was cutting this guy's hair.
He weren't wanking when you
did. Yeah,
he did.
He was wanking.
Under the thing.
Was he really?
Under the gown. You are making some random stuff.
I'm not, Emily. I promise on your life it's true.
Oh.
That is just so. You need therapy for that, firstly.
No.
Secondly, I just feel like that nowadays is so unbelievably, like, you'd get done for sexual assault.
He was staring at me in the mirror.
Oh.
I could feel his eyes burning through me. And I was like a bunny rabbit in the head, because I'm gobby, you know, I wasn't scared of. And in any situation, if somebody said that to me, I'd have said to him, oi, you dirty bugger.
Bastard.
Stop it now, otherwise I'm calling you out. I just carried on cutting his hair.
And then what did he do when he left? gift?
Oh, I can't remember. Blank.
Did he give you a tip?
Yeah.
Did you hide when he left?
Oh, I just literally took the gown off and ran out to the staff room and said to the receptionist, you can take the bill.
But yeah, yeah. I don't know. Yeah, just disgusting.
If anybody was telling me this, oh, you know what I would have done?
Well, of course, because people, when you're doing the story, you have the kind of courage of a lion, don't you, until you're in that position. I would have got my size 5.5, you know, shears and nipped into it.
Yeah, I would have got me Joelles.
Your Joelles. Your Jaguars.
Yeah. Dilemma time, coming in your ears. Emily and Rach with some crap advice for you.
Wow.
So there we go, guys. One part of our podcast that we like to do is our dilemmas. So we thought, while you guys are here, you can help us solve the problems of the world.
I can't wait.
First one. Here we go. This is from one of our lovely listeners.
Bonjour.
So I've been going out with my boyfriend for just over 1 year now, and in general, things have been great. However, I've noticed when it comes to sex, he's not seemed himself recently. I've asked him about this a few times, but now I never get a real answer. This week we had a bit of a breakthrough. It turns out it's because he's got a fetish that he thinks I'd have a problem with, so I was worried how to react how this would impact our relationship. The fetish is belly buttons. I've literally never heard of this fetish before. The problem is I'm actually a little weird about my belly button. I think it's a slight phobia. He likes innies, which I have, and to finger and lick them, which makes me queasy. Sorry, this isn't funny. This is seriously weird. So now I'm wondering what to do. I've heard you can get counselling for these sort of things.
What, for belly buttons?
Hello, belly button line.
Hi there.
Belly button hotline.
Can I put you through to innie or outie department?
Oh my God, the world's gone insane.
So, right.
He likes to
lick and finger a belly button.
Yeah.
But there's so many other things to finger and lick. Do you know what I mean?
But these fetishes are real these days. The world is going stranger. I remember there was this one guy who someone sent me, or one of it went around our friend's group chat, who had a fetish for putting on blow up, like holding blow up ring. What are they called? Inflatables.
Oh.
A guy who had an inflatable fetish. Right. So it wasn't inflatable of, like, you know, a person. It was inflatable of, like,
a unicorn.
A unicorn or a palm tree. He would just stand there and hold an inflatable and smile because he loved them.
Oh, well, that's... Would he do anything with them?
Yeah, the whole belly button
thing. The belly button thing does freak me out, because my little boy, right, he's 3, and if I'm, like, laying there without a top on, he likes to poke his finger in. And to tell you what, when you hit the bottom of that belly button, Christ, the feeling of it's awful.
Yeah.
It's like you're going through the centre of the earth.
Yeah.
No thanks. And if he's sticking something else in there, fuck off.
No, do you know what is awful? You know, like, when, like, men are a bit chubbier and they have an innie, and then they'll have like fluff in the belly button.
Yeah, but doesn't everyone get
fluff? Didn't Dad used to go, ooh, and pretend when I used to go...
Yes, he did. He used to pretend that somebody lived in there.
So when I was younger, I used to go like on his belly button and he would be like, ooh, hello. That someone was living in his belly button. So not that he has a belly button fetish, let me just clear that up.
You never know.
But
so going back to this, if she can't bear the feeling of it, of him licking and fingering her belly button, then she's not going to get excited for what comes after foreplay.
I think relationships are about compromise.
Mm.
So I feel like, why don't you come up with like a little, you know, do you know what, hun? If you like the belly button situation, you can have it once or twice a year.
Twice a year.
Once
or twice, like, yeah.
It's compromising, isn't it?
I think so, but if it's really going to put her off...
She can do it once
or
twice. Listen,
but I don't think a belly button's that bad.
No, Jesus, there's definitely worse.
There's
I would rather a belly button than the foot fetish.
Yeah, I mean...
Toes and fingers in my mouth. Yeah, I think compromise. I think that's the best solution. Suck it up for twice, quite literally, for...
a couple of times a year.
Twice a year, and, you know, then call it a day.
What, split up with him?
No, just like...
Well, that's an alternative.
Yeah, it is, actually.
Go rogue.
Do you imagine? Why did you split up with your ex? Well, you wanted to lick my belly button twice a year.
Finger and licking.
Finger and licking. A bit KFC-esque.
Bargain bucket vibes.
Bargain bucket. You never know.
Yeah.
Okay, the second dilemma. Do you want to read this one?
No, you can read.
I'm not very good at reading. Sorry, guys.
Don't worry.
My best friend recently opened up to me that she has been catfishing her ex-boyfriend online. Oh. They broke up 2 months ago, and it was a pretty rough breakup. She found out he had started dating again, so she decided to make a fake account on Hinge to see what his profile was. When she found it, she liked his profile and he liked her back. They ended up starting a conversation and a few exchanges. He revealed that he had recently gone through a breakup. She was asking him questions about, this is genius, what she was like, do you still love her, etc., to find out how he really feels. They've been messaging back and forth for weeks now, and I just think it's really weird and wrong. As he has no idea it's her, do I intervene? I mean, I wouldn't personally do it because I wouldn't actually want to know the answers. But God, what's she going to say?
The thing is, she's still hung up on him to do
really?
That, right?
Oh, got to be.
So
yeah, it must be. Yeah.
If you, because they're broken up. Who broke up with who?
I don't know. They didn't say it. Well, quite clearly, he broke up.
He
with
broke
her.
Up with her, so she's trying to get some gossip, which is an absolute
she's
brilliant idea.
To find out why they broke up.
As the friend who has DM'd us this dilemma, personally, what I would do is just explain to your friend that's doing it that it's going to hold her back from moving on.
Exactly. Yeah,
so in definitely. Order for her to move on and find the right person, she definitely needs to give up this fake Hinge account and just say, sorry, I don't know, make up some excuse.
Yeah, chapter then... closed, move on.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's keeping herself tied to that painful
she don't thing. She don't want to move on, and the poor bloke's then thinking he's got himself a really nice bird.
Yeah.
Also, what if they want to meet up and then she turns up and think, fucking hell, not again.
No, but that should be on TV. That's brilliant.
There is a TV program, isn't it?
Yeah, Catfish.
Catfish.
Oh, if you like Catfish. Pina Coladas, it's that song, isn't it?
If you like Pina Colada. No, what a great song.
Well, basically, he reads in the... He's married and they're... relationship's gone a bit off the boil.
Wait, are you talking about the lyrics of this song?
Yeah, the lyrics of the song. If you listen to them.
Oh!
So he reads in an ad, if you like pina coladas and dancing
in the rain.
Getting caught in the rain. You know, right. So he writes to her, because we didn't have text nor phone in that. Well, we did have phone in. So he writes to her and they arrange to meet and it's his wife. And then they're laughing, saying, I didn't know you liked pina coladas. And Kate Bush, Babushka, is the same sort of setup. She wanted to test her husband. She knew exactly what to do.
Oh, my God, what in his... So catfishing's gone back a long way.
Yeah.
It's still going on now.
I did not know that. Right, interesting.
Yeah, they've just rebranded it.
Well, basically rebranded it. It's also very easy to do to catfish, yeah. You should try it one day, Dad. That would be funny, wouldn't it?
No, it wouldn't be.
Okay.
Not with who I'm married to.
No, she'll cut your nails off.
I've been told, Stanley. Not
yeah, Stanley.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I've been told, yeah.
I don't say cut off, I say castrate.
Castrate.
Yeah, it's the same, same.
It's not worth the risk.
One's nuts and one's shaft, so.
Yeah.
Either or is not good.
Yeah, it just ain't worth the risk.
No. Grass is
I'm quite happy, actually.
All needs mowing.
Yeah.
Unless anyway, guys, thank you so much for coming on. We've had such a nice little hour with you both.
It's been great.
We're really looking forward to coming onto your podcast as well.
It's going to be amazing. Hope you can hope you can join us.
Yeah, I hope you can make it.
It'll be out soon.
When's it out? Yeah, Do you know the exact date yet?
Well, we don't know an exact date yet. We're going to do the final run through the end of this week. We've got some guests lined up already, you included, and it's going to be just a load of fun.
Yeah,
about today.
Just fun.
So the roles will be reversed, but it's going to be great fun. So, yeah.
Yeah, no, looking forward to it.
Love it. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you want to do your outro and what's your favourite thing to do?
As usual, guys, thank you very much for tuning in to Mother Half Podcast. Please like, subscribe, and rate. Find us on any platform. We prefer Spotify or YouTube.
Wow.
I don't know where that comes from.
That was
You're
great.
Very good. You just go straight into it.